Hey, this is Kevin Kitchens with Once Upon a Game, and I'm in the midst of a two-player solo game of Mark Walker's 65 squad level combat in the jungles of Vietnam. I've not adapted or integrated the solo AI in those missions yet, but I'm just playing the base game, and I was going to do a quick little gameplay brief here to show you how it works. This is a quick little game, scenario one. I'll just show you a little bit of how I play it solo. On turn three, one thing the game doesn't give you is a way to track the turn markers. So, there's no turn track. So you can probably do that with dice or a counter die or something like that. I just use these little gold icons, a little gold cubicle. Woo, it's late. The little gold cubes. And so it tells me I'm on turn three and I have the other four of them sitting right there. I bring them down as each turn starts. So the situation here is the blue is the NVA, I believe. I'll look that up real quick in the scenario book. Actually, it's not in the scenario book. It's in the introduction. And we have here that the... somewhere. The Viet Cong are blue. So it's not the NVA, it's the Viet Cong. The NVA are these guys here. So that's all cool. This is the Viet Cong and the American forces. And the Americans are entering from this side and from this side. And they set up in the first three rows of hexes here. There's one thing with these geomorphic boards. This is where the boards meet here. You'll see that they don't line up perfectly. So they didn't, the printing, it's not a big deal. I'm not really complaining about it too terribly much. I'm just observing. So they don't line up. So the only time that would really give you an issue is obviously there's no center dots here. So when you're doing line of sight, you make it a little tricky. As you know, there's not a center dot, and I mean, there's a center, obviously. But anyway, it could, you know, it's not that big a deal. It's not you know, a precision game. It's a fun, quick play game. So, what's going on here? So when you start the turn, each turn you reshuffle the deck because there are four end turn cards in there. And the scenario specifies that when three of them have turned up, the turn is over. You finish combat. If it came up in the middle of the combat, you'd finish out that combat, and then it's over. So anybody that you, there's a cleanup phase or a reserve phase where anyone who has not moved yet can move, and then a cleanup phase where you reset all the counters and everything. It's not looking good for the Americans right now. Each side has lost a unit. We got their sappers, and they got a rifle team, and an artillery strike that took these guys down. An artillery strike hits one hex within line of sight and two adjacent hexes. So I hit this one and this one. The Viet Cong hit this one and this one, and these guys are all healthy to start with. And they immediately got shaken and reduced. So they're in a bad way right there. So that's one thing, is you kind of don't have units grouped together if you don't have to. So at the end of all that, then you start the new turn, you shuffle the cards, and you deal back up to four for each side. So I just keep the Americans here and the Viet Cong here. And then, in a normal two-player game, you would bid for initiative. And then the side that wins loses that card that they bid, and the side that lost gets to keep their card. So then the first round, the one who won initiative would have three cards to choose from, and the one who lost initiative would still have all four. And you draw up at the beginning of your impulse, so... you know, it's only that one, that first impulse of the turn that you're out. But because I can't bid against myself, I just roll dice. And so I use the blue die for the Viet Cong and the red die for the Americans. And so this time If I tie, I just reroll. The Americans did win the initiative, and that worked. The Viet Cong have won it first two turns. Americans got second turn. So now what I do is I got my four cards here, and since I've got it, I'm supposed to lose a card. Then I do a roll, one through four, and I get a, let's see, this is a one. So I'll lose the first grip. Which is a, oh darn, that's a panic card. That's a good card to have, because if the Viet Cong had this play after attacking, that's a leg unit, obviously leg unit, and you can remove him. So if the Viet Cong had this, this guy was shaken and reduced. He could have just removed him from the game. So I lost that. I was holding on to that one. So I wanted that. So anyway, let's see a couple of impulses here and see where we go. Showing the thought processes, which you veteran grognards are going to be more. And you're like, what is he doing? He's such an idiot. All right. So the way the cards work, when you're holding them in your hand, you're going to use one of these two options. And you can pick from them. Red is a reaction. So that I could play that when he does something to me. Green is an action I can take on my turn. And yellow is a support card. It's one of theirs. It's yellow. It's a support card that you would play to supplement your action. So if I was doing a fire here, I could add one. But it's their card, so I can't use it. So since I have the initiative, I want to try to strike fast. The downside is that shaken units are severely limited in what they can do. So that's not good at all. I've got a sniper here. And the sniper is really good in that his sniper ability is always available in his dead shot or kill shot power. Would activate on a card that had a power one here. Again, it would be gone. So they've got this. So if you played this card, one of these actions, and it has power on it, then you can use the power of the unit that's being affected. So if I fired with him, I would get that. And that would be helpful. So a sniper, he has no range penalties, but he also gets no range bonuses. Okay, so he can shoot all the way pretty much across the board. But the other benefit that he gets is that the target unit does not benefit from cover. This guy is in a red dot building, which means he gets a two cover. So that would be negated by a sniper. There's their sniper there. A black dot building gives you a one cover. Smaller, you know, sticks and stones. Building, whereas this is more of a wood structure, so it gives you a little more power and a little more protection. But a sniper can overrule that. But a shaken unit cannot fire. Now, these cubes, I should explain, these cubes do not come with the game. These are some cubes I bought from the Miniature Market. And they use them for all sorts of games. But the counters they give you, there's a fired counter, there's a moved counter, and the shaken counter is right here. It's kind of gray, so I use a gray counter. The problem I have is that these cover the whole unit, you know, and you can kind of adjust them and stuff like that, but you lose a little more sight as to what's there. So I've just kind of taken where I did this with the Knight of Man as well, and used the cubes to allow me to see the unit a little bit more clearly. These are very nice counters. They're just the same size, and so they're a little hard to see. But with shaken, I cannot fire. It tells me I cannot fire, and I can only move half. So these guys are in trouble. another. I'm not a huge user. Obviously, the same color. I have the gray. I have green, and I have red. Ops complete is like you're done. You're completely done. I may have an actual purple, but I just use that kind of like lavender ink for it. A little hard on. Okay, so off to figure out what I want to do. We'll do that right now. Okay, so I got these guys sitting over here that were coming in. They moved up during the reserve phase. They managed to move a little closer to this guy. This is Kanai grass. It blocks line of sight. This is brush, and it degrades line of sight. If you were firing from here to here, it would block because we got two hexes of it. Firing from here over to here does not block because it's only one. It degrades it, but you have to have two degrading hexes to block the line of sight. So anyway, what am I going to do? I could fire with this. Excuse me, with this rifle team at the RPD, and they how firing works is right now there's no vehicles on the board in this scenario, so everything is going to use the HE ammo, and this is their HE number right here. So you can activate with a fire card. I can play this card to fire with an eligible unit or group of units. So I've got these two units here I can fire together. So you pick one to be in the lead, you take the two, you'd add one for the support fire. They would both be marked as fired. So they could both fire here, that's a three. And there's no penalties going across. And he gets a one for the black support, or the black cover for the building. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna use the fire card, and then I'm going to support him, and he gets one, so it's three minus one is two. So what I'm looking for when using a fire card is you have a chart here that tells you if your action is a fire card, not a moving fire or anything like that, or any special ones, but just a straight up fire card. You're going to hit on green hits. So the cool thing about this game is that you use the cards for both the actions and for your hit markers. So these three cards that I have are all green hits. This is the for vehicle combat, for the targeting number. I always have to look it up. But the main one I'm really just concerned about here with just soft targets today is just this word hit or no hit. And they're very, very easy because they've got three colors, but you'll notice all these were green hits. That has no bearing on this attack because these are my action cards. The one I'm going to draw in the draw pile when I resolve the combat. So that's what we're going to do. Just go ahead and do that real quick. Alright, talking way too much about it, but just want to make sure you understood. So there we go. Got a fire card. The number was 2, 3, minus 1 is 2. So we're going to draw these cards. So I draw two cards, and just, all I'm looking at is for that hit resolution or an end turn marker. Alright, so that is a yellow. So that's a miss. And that's one hit, one shot. And that's nothing. So all of that was for naught. We missed it. So I discard my fire card. And then they both fired. So I'm going to put on them each a red marker. Says they fired. And that's it. Now, at the end of my turn, I can say I can discard up to two cards. If there's cards here that I do not want. So this one is only good for a vehicle attack, armor piercing. And this allows me to just draw another card. So I think I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that one. So I can discard that. And then I am done. Because I don't draw until the start of my impulse. And we're going to go to get on the side. I think we're going to hopefully be able to do something here with Miss Sniper Girl.
I think it's a girl. I don't know. I don't know how to pronounce that. No? Yo? Whoa? But anyway, I keep calling her Sniper Girl when it may be a guy. I don't know.
So here we go. What do we got? We have a fire or move with a power. We have a command ops, which allows me to play two additional actions. If I play this card, I get to play two actions. Reloading fire, which is good later in a turn. A unit marked fire can fire down the original target. So if I had this on the American side, I could use this guy and fire just him. They can give it a shot at that same target, which takes a little, you know, hopefully these don't get real big where you forget who did he fire at, because it's not a support, it's not a reaction, it's a new action. So you're doing it on a subsequent impulse. All right. Oh, we got a bullet storm, which adds one to the high explosive fire if they're a leg unit. So any, you know, a fire, I can get, draw one more card. And there's also glancing shot, which is the same thing we had for the army version. And then we got, let's get them, move all eligible like units in two hexes that begin within two hexes of each other. So the Viet Cong here are defending, really, so there's not a lot of movement going on. I do have this guy that needs to get to cover somehow, but right now he's kind of protected. The Kanai blocks him from these guys, and he probably could actually get hit by those guys up there, but they're more concerned with that guy. So anyway, you could pick, like, if I wanted to move, I could take these guys or these guys and move them together. And then that's a reaction, which when they're attacking me, when they're attacking the Viet Cong side, you can, it's basically found cover, so you get to reduce the number of cards they draw. So I think we're going to put, going to use Sniper with the power, because it gives that kill shot, which allows her to draw an extra card. And she is going to actually go here for this leader. And I made a mistake of having this leader by himself. If this rifle unit had been here, you can't shoot the hero until you take out the other units. But he got separated early on in the initial moves, so she can go right at him. He is already shaken, so two hits will take him out of the game. She can play the fire card with the power. So again, that gives one. Got one plus one for the kill shot, and we are going to go ahead and take a chance and play the bullet storm with it, which gives three, and then he gets no cover reduction, and he can't, with a sniper, you can't use cover reduction for cards. So if he had the unexpected cover card on the American side, he couldn't even use that. Snipers are obviously deadly, as they would be. All right, so we're looking at 1, 2, 3, no reduction for cover, three draws, it's a fire card, looking for green. On our draws, we have one hit. Okay, so that is going to reduce him. The reason you go ahead and do it is because you stop drawing cards as soon as you've eliminated the unit. So that's one hit. That was a red hit, so it's not a hit. Third card. No hit. Wow, survived that one. So that is it for the sniper. Discard the two cards I played. Mark the sniper as having fired. And so I don't get rid of the card. And I do not. Just hang on to those. And now back to the American impulse. And essentially that's how the game goes, back and forth. You want to manage the timing of the deck. There are, like I said, 4 intern cards in there. And when 3 of them come up, either when you're drawing into your hand or you're drawing cards for combat resolution, you have to set them aside. So you can't hoard them in your hand. The player, you draw them, it's honor system. You have to put it aside. When 3 of those have built up, the turn's over. So let's go ahead and do another quick impulse. I'll try to do less explaining this time. So I've got 1 card, I get to draw 3 cards. Fire and move with power. Got a bloodlust and a fast move. And a critical hit and reinforce. No endurance cards have come up here yet. Unfortunately, the critical hit doesn't do me any good because it's for hard targets. So I'm going to actually use the reinforcement card first. I play that and I can draw another card. Does not count as an action. So I play that, draw me a card. Cool, got light wounds. That'll help me. Ignores a hit. There I got to reload and fire. So it's a 2 minus 1. I'm going to shoot there again. So I think I'll do that and keep my options open. Goes back in there. So we'll use the reload and fire on one of these guys here. So 2 minus 1 is just a 1 card draw. Looking for a green. You know what? I'm gonna make sure that the reload and fire uses the same thing. I think it does because it's a fire action. To make sure, yeah. Fire, reload, and fire, and flanking fire on the green. Okay, so we draw, and we get a red. So, all that for naught is a miss. But then, reload and fire, you have to place ops complete. Oh, we missed that. Add 1 to HEF or accuracy. So you have to draw a second card. Try to get hits. In this case, we do. We got a green hit. There's 1 hit. On this guy, which will shake him first. New shaken marker. I'll put the shaken marker on him there. That's a silver one. That's fine. And then the one who fired loses his fire marker and he becomes ops complete, which basically means he's not going to be able to do anything the rest of the turn, because he has none. So you see there's some cards here that let a fired unit already fire again, or a moved unit, you know, move again, or do something. Once you go ops complete, you're pretty much done. So that was the American side, and I'm not going to discard anything. So real quick, we'll go to the Viet Cong side. There are 2 cards, so we draw 2 more. 1, fast move aim shot. And that only helps on our targets. And move and fire around. Wow, no intern cards have come up yet. First turn, we had 2 intern cards in the initial draws. So that turn actually went longer than I thought, because there were only 2 left in the deck. The second turn, we had 1 come up early. The second one came up pretty quick, and it took a little while to get to the third one. And so far, we had none of them show up. So each, there's that, you know, variability of when the turn is actually going to end, which is really pretty cool. So I like the card play in this a lot. So let's see. Excuse me. Well, you know what? Reload and fire. Single unit marked fire may fire again at the original target. Add 1 for accuracy. So we're going to let Snapper Girl take another shot. And nothing to support that. So, in this case, it's not a power card. She'll still get to use her ability for the sniper, which means he gets no cover. She couldn't use the headshot, the kill shot, but she gets a +1 here. So she's still going to draw 2 cards on him, and he still doesn't get his cover. So we're looking for green, and he is already reduced. So and there's a green hit. So like I said, we stop drawing. We've got the hit. He's hit and reduced. Next reduction takes him out. Over there in their trophy pile. And that's out. And she goes to ops complete. She was pretty much done for the day. And discard the cards. Nothing I want to get rid of. And that was that impulse. So you get to where it starts moving real quick. Reason I'm keeping track of the trophies here, I'll show you, is they have these bonus victory condition cards that give you extra points when the game's over. And for the Americans, eliminate 25% more enemy units than you lose. So you can keep track of that. The Vietcong's bonus condition is to conduct a flank attack. It's not enough to play a flank attack card, but you must also use an extra squad. I've not played a flank attack yet or looked at it, but basically it allows two units to join from different hexes of attack. Anyway, that's just what that is, and that's their thing. If they use that, they'll get a bonus point. So that is briefly the gameplay of 65. Very similar to Knight of Man. They made some definite improvements with the counters. The hex system, I think, works a lot better. Really simple once you get it down. You get a lot of counters if you get the whole Kickstarter version. You know, Marines, Anzac troops, stuff like that. Got all the markers and stuff in a GMT tray. Those are the markers for the solitaire game. And there you go. Hope you enjoyed watching a quick little playthrough of 65. Thanks for watching.